Sherry Salivi. I'm from New York originally, but we've lived in Florida for several decades. My female forms are very sensual. My installations are very calm and reflective. My work in tar and different mediums is a little more provocative, like my tattooed female deities. The sculpture, I think, is very sensual. A lot of female forms, although I do work in faces and heads and male bodies. My favorite tools, well, I would have to say this is number one. Anything you could possibly want. I'm a little mini Home Depot. This one is also bronze. I did this in black Belgium marble. This is black Belgium. And then I had a cast, and I have more of a watery patina on that. I do gigantic mobiles, which are part of some of my installations, and I put beds underneath them so that you have to lay down and relax and watch it go around. Like a giant crib. I'm into vinyl now, which I just love. What is something that most people don't know about me? I grew up on a farm, and most people think of me as a city girl. So I'm a city farm girl. Definitely reach out to the cultural affairs in every city that you live in, because they're just as passionate about art as you are, and they're not going to find you hidden in your studio. So you need to get out and show them who you are. Listen to your small voice. What is the small voice? The small voice is when you look at a sculpture and there's something nagging to you about it, why it's not right, and you keep saying, oh, it'll be all right. It's not going to be all right. You have to face those little decisions all along the way. I'm not as timid as I thought I was. I'm more aggressive than I thought I was. I'm more powerful in the mediums that I've chosen, because they're difficult ones, and the scale of things. So the little voice is a big voice now.